Five Rap Groups That Broke Up, Part 1. Over the past few decades, exceptional hip-hop groups have come and gone, each one of them showcasing their own individual styles while also assisting in the longevity of the hip-hop genre. Like with any breakup, when it first occurs, the fresh wound stings, but we learn to accept fate as time passes. Some of them stopped producing music together due to nasty feuds, lawsuits, and others decided to split because they knew their music had run its course. In this video, we take a detailed look at five of the best rap groups that broke up. But before we begin, kindly show us some love by subscribing to our channel so that you can continue enjoying more of our amazing content. Please give us a like, share the video, and don't forget to turn on the notification bell for timely updates of our weekly uploads. Let's get it on! Number 1. Little Brother. This is one group that started as a trio. The members of the group were rappers Fonte Coleman, rapper Big Pooh, Thomas Jones, and DJ-producer Ninth Wonder, Pat Douthat. Interestingly, they met in 1998 while enrolled as college students at North Carolina Central University in Durham, North Carolina. Unlike other rap groups, this group was a victim of what I would call the gangstar effect, where the producer's acclaim and popularity surpassed that of the group members he came in the door with. Little Brother seemed stuck in the underground and looked at odd by television networks and radio stations that apparently couldn't make anything of them because they possessed no clear marketing gimmick outside of their dope beats and rhymes. However, a good deal of underground rap fans adored them, and somehow the group's music seemed to have picked up where A Tribe Called Quest left off. It was only a matter of time before the trio went their separate ways, as Ninth Wonder's production was being sought by high-profile acts like Jay-Z, Destiny's Child, and Erykah Badu. Number 2. Hot Boyz. This was one of New Orleans' biggest contributions to the rap world. The members were Juvenile, Lil Wayne, BG, and Turk. They were signed to Birdman's Cash Money Records. The group was on fire after releasing prolific music and had many singles on the charts. They were so good at their rap that their album Guerrilla Warfare picked up number 5 on the Billboard Hot 100. Their record dealer Birdman caused their downfall as he began focusing more on one member, Lil Wayne. Birdman felt that Lil Wayne had more to offer and that he was the actual star of the group. This made the other members feel the pressure, and one by one, they left the group, leaving Wayne alone by 2003. Many say that Wayne should have left after seeing him spend most of his career fighting Birdman and his label. It was so bad that he even called himself a prisoner under contract to Cash Money Records. There has never been a reunion of the members to this day. Although Birdman has mended his relationship with Turk and Juvenile, it's unclear what to make of his relationship with BG, who is currently serving time in jail. Number 3. Tribe Called Quest. The Quest was a tribe formed in 1985 out of Queens, New York, and comprised of members MC Q-Tip, MC Fife Dawg, and DJ Ali Shaheed Muhammad. The group released 5 albums, including People's Instinctive Travels in the Paths of Rhythm, 1990, The Low End Theory, 1991, Midnight Marauders, 1993, Beats, Rhymes, and Life, 1996, and The Love Movement, 1998. They also released 5 compilations, including Revised Quest for the Seasoned Traveler, 1992, The Anthology, 1999, Hits, Rarities, and Remixes, 2003, The Lost Tribes, 2006, and The Best of a Tribe Called Quest, 2008. Many recognized and loved them for their positive and good-natured representation of hip-hop music. Unfortunately, the group members went their separate ways, and some pursued solo careers after the release of The Love Movement in 1998. According to the group, one of the major reasons for their breakup was their frustration with their record label Jive Zomba. During Rock the Bells concert on November 13, 2004, the group reunited to perform as a headlining slot. Sadly, that same night, Old Dirty Bastard died. After this, there was no hope of reuniting as Old Dirty Bastard's death shook them. However, they performed together in 2006 for several festival appearances and in 2008 and 2010 at Rock the Bells. They came together again for a bunch of festival appearances. Also, they served as a supporting act for 2 out of the 4 concerts for Kanye West's Yeezus tour, which A Tribe Called Quest labeled as their last performances ever. Number 4. N.W.A. This has to be perhaps one of the most famous downfalls in history. The group comprised some of today's biggest names in the hip-hop industry, such as Dr. Dre, Ice Cube, and included rappers Arabian Prince, DJ Yella, and Eazy-E. The group was founded in 1986 by Dr. Dre, and it quickly gained controversy and traction, mostly because of their violent lyrics. They seemed to glorify violence, drug use, and perpetually the gangster lifestyle. NWA released their debut album Straight Outta Compton in 1988, which helped bring gangster rap to the forefront of rap music and altered the trajectory of hip-hop music in general. While others saw success in the music, some saw exploitation, and their manager quickly turned the group members against each other. Due to contract disputes, Arabian Prince left the group shortly after the debut album release. Ice Cube left the group due to royalty disputes in 1989 and pursued a successful solo career. In 1990, the group went on without Cube and released their EP, 100 Miles and Running. The hit contained several lyrics bashing the former member. This led to the famous feud between NWA and Cube. In 1995, Eazy-E was diagnosed with AIDS, which caused some members to cool off their tension and even reunite in tours and shows after Eazy's death. NWA disbanded in 1991 after Dr. Dre and the DOC left Ruthless Records and joined Death Row Records. Number 5. Run-DMC. Run-DMC comprised Joseph Simmons, Rev Run, Daryl McDaniels, and Jam Master Jay, who first went by Mizell. They released 7 studio albums, 4 compilation albums, and 1 live album. Being one of the first groups to represent the new school wave in hip-hop music, they became one of the vital groups in the history of hip-hop culture. They were the first mainstream act to emphasize the importance of the MC and DJ relationship. Also, this was the first hip-hop group to attain a gold album, a platinum record, to earn a multi-platinum certification, to have their videos on MTV, to appear on American Bandstand, and to be on the cover of Rolling Stone. I guess you could say they had it all figured out by then. Besides, the group was the very first in their music genre to be nominated for a Grammy Award. Many say that many reasons led to the split of Run-DMC. After the release of 1993's Down With The King, the group hardly recorded any new material for the next 7 years. For example, Simmons had already adopted a more spiritual outlook on life and eventually became a reverend. At around the same time, McDaniels suffered from depression and substance abuse. Despite all these, they recorded one more album, 2001's Crown Royal, which led them to join Aerosmith on their worldwide Walk This Way tour. Unfortunately, Simmons was tired of the music industry and wanted to focus more on his family and his brother Russell's Fat Farm clothing company. He showed his disinterest when he announced that he was quitting Run-DMC while the group was on its way to one of their performances with Aerosmith. Afterward, more bad news hit when Jam Master Jay was shot and killed at his recording studio in Queens. That unfortunate event more than placed the last nail on the group's coffin. Did you enjoy our video? Which of these groups was your favorite? And what are some of their songs you enjoy to date? Well, if you enjoyed our video, be sure to subscribe to our channel for more of our amazing content. Please give us a like, share the video, and don't forget to turn on the notification bell for timely updates of our weekly uploads. We value your feedback. Feel free to share your thoughts with us in the comments section below.